Good morning, everyone. I have to speak about history, but before that, I think I would like to point out certain things because this was my second attempt, and I feel there are certain things that worked for me this time, which I did not follow in my previous attempt. Firstly, when I thought of mains answer writing, I read Gaurav Agarwal's and Ira Singhal's blogs because they were the previous year's toppers. And one thing that I realized was common between the two of them was that they mentioned that you must always write answers in points. Some of you might differ with me, but I feel what happens when you write in points is that you tend to write to the point, very crisp answers. You don't write generalized statements. So I think that probably that's why point mein answer likhna is a much better way to go about it. Also, I remember even when I wrote about history, culture, I drew diagrams wherever I could. I made mind maps. Even in questions where you might think that isme hum nahi bana sakte. So please, wo practice, I think you must start doing it now, that even when you're reading history or something as boring as culture, you must make mind maps, you must make certain pointers which you will use in your main exam. Because what happens in main exam, there's hardly any time. I'm sure some of you have written mains and you know that there's absolutely no time to think. So please do that practice at home regarding diagrams, regarding writing in points, and that will really help you. Also, never write general statements in your answer. For example, India is a poor country, India is underdeveloped, our literacy levels are low. I mean, everyone is going to write that. So if you are going to point out that India's literacy is low, always have some data to back up your statement. So if you can do that, then your answer will be slightly different than others. So never write general statements. I used to write it in my previous attempt. I remember I would write in paras and I would write a lot of basic stuff, which I'm sure every other candidate was writing. And that didn't help me at all. So that is one thing that you need to realize, that you have very little space, very little time. So just be, try and be different from others. And that is something that you can work a way out for yourself. I mean, nobody else is going to do that for you. But we can guide you. But the thinking process, having your own opinion about things, that is something that you have to sit when you read about a topic. Please, 5 minutes, just think about that topic. What have you understood out of it? And that opinion that you will form after reading it, that will stay in your mind for long. And then when you see that question in the answer, you won't really require time to think. It will just flow from your subconscious. And I feel mains answer writing is about things that are there somewhere in your subconscious mind, because you hardly have time to think. So aapke dimag mein already jo fit hai over the period of time that you've learned, you will be writing that in your final examination hall. Also, history ki baat karein. History, I remember I am able to recollect certain questions that were there in the exam. For example, there was this question about Hitler and Germany, how this was solely responsible for the World War. And I remember I wrote about Hitler, I wrote about Germany, everything. But then when I said that just one person cannot be responsible for something, I quoted what is happening in the Middle East, Syria, Iraq. And I said that it's not just Iraq which was responsible for what happened to it. USA was equally responsible. The entire Arab world was responsible because they... then I spoke about Saudi Arabia and how there's no unity among the Middle East countries. Then I also spoke about USA. So this was something that I wrote in a Second World War question, which wanted me to speak about Germany. It might think you might think it's stupid, but I feel every answer has to be connected to something which is happening right now. So that is very important. For example, if there's a question on Gandhiji, so everybody will write about non-violence and stuff like that, but you connect it to some ongoing program that is going on right now about the government. Garima mission is going on, I think, about manual scavengers. So when you write about Gandhiji, you also write about the ongoing schemes of the government, how these schemes are connected to his ideas, and I think that will fetch you marks, because Gandhiji's schemes, whatever he said, everybody is going to write it. I mean, your answer will not be different from anyone, and what will set your thing apart will be something current that you're going to write, and that will be in your mind only when you're very thorough with current affairs. So please do not ignore newspaper reading. I think for most people it's a pain to read newspaper every day, but I feel and very strongly that if you discard all notes of all coaching institutes and you only stick to newspapers and basic books, I think you are sorted. You do not need any other source. But of course, answer writing, like Sir said, like Anshul said, answer writing is very important, because some people, I think, are gifted with very nice writing skills, but I think some people have to develop it. It's not impossible for anyone, but you have to realize certain things. And like I said, please write in points, please draw diagrams, even in the most stupid of questions, even in history, culture, please try and just make your answer a little different than others. I think that will really help you out. That's it. Thank you.